Word. And we'll be reading from Daniel chapter 6, verses 19 to 27. Let's read these verses responsively, as we usually do. Daniel chapter 6, verses 19 to 27. And I'm reading from the English Standard Version. This is the Word of God. Then, at the break of day, the king arose and went into haste to the den of lions. Then Daniel said to the king, O king, live forever. My God sent his angel and shut the mouths, lions' mouths, and they have not harmed me, because I was found blameless before him. And also before you, O king, I have done no harm. And the king commanded, and these men who had maliciously accused Daniel were brought and cast into the den of lions, they, their children, and their wives. And before they reached the bottom of the den, the lions overpowered them and broke all their bones in pieces. I make a decree that in all my royal dominion, people are to tremble and fear before the God of Daniel, for he is the living God, enduring forever. His kingdom shall never be destroyed, and his dominion shall be to the end. He delivers and rescues, he works signs and wonders in heaven and on earth. He who has saved Daniel from the power of the lions, amen. What a beautiful passage this is. I'd like to start my message today by going back in history, English history, a little bit. Back in the 16th century, there was a pastor, a bishop to be exact, by the name of Hugh Latimer. Some of you have heard him, and some of you have never heard of him in your life. Maybe you could vaguely remember from him from your world history somewhere. This pastor, this bishop, he was in a time of history when the nation was changing from Catholicism to Anglicanism, you know, the city, the church state, right? He was somebody who was a proponent of Protestantism, saying that let's go back to the Bible, let's understand what God has said to us and live by it, not by human tradition of the church. And he happened to be a chaplain in the king's court. And there is a incident when he was preaching before the king, Henry VIII. And it is said that he presented the king with a very special Bible with markings in the Bible where he thought was relevant for the king's life. He started to preach a very heated message, a fervent message before the king. But it was a very uncomfortable message for the king because the king had